थॉमस हेवुड लाइफ एंड वर्क्स अ वुमन किल्ड विद काइंडनेस सिनोप्सिस। हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द डिस्कोर्स। वी आर डिस्कसिंग द प्ले राइट्स ऑफ द जैकोबियन एंड कैरोलीन एरा। थॉमस हेवुड वॉज द मोस्ट प्रोलिफिक प्ले राइट, एक्टर एंड ऑथर ऑफ द जैकोबियन एरा। बाय हिज ओन एडमिशन ही हैड एन एंटायर हैंड और एटलीस्ट अ मेन फिंगर इन 220 प्लेस। ही क्लेम्ड दिस इन द प्रीफेस ऑफ द प्रिंटेड वर्जन ऑफ वन ऑफ हिज most successful plays titled A Woman Killed with Kindness. Heywood's year of birth is not certain, but most probably he was born between 1575 and 1589, and he died and was buried on 16th August 1641. He wrote many noteworthy plays, poems, chronicle plays, poetry, masques and prose or essays. Charles Lamb praised Heywood's work and claimed that Heywood was prose Shakespeare. German poet Johann Ludwig Tieck called him the model of a light and rare talent. Major works of Heywood. We will discuss six major works of Thomas Heywood. The first one is the drama The Four Prentices of London, which was first performed in 1594 and was printed in 1615. This play was specifically produced to attract the apprentices of London of that time. It is a romantic play that tells the story of four brothers, sons of the Earl of Boulogne, who loses his earldom because of a conspiracy against him. He gives away whatever little wealth he had to his daughter Bella Franca, while his four sons Godfrey, Guy, Charles and Eustace become apprentices to learn skills and earn a living. Their father leaves Britain for Jerusalem for pilgrimage. Godfrey becomes a mercer, Guy becomes a goldsmith, Charlie a haberdasher and Eustace becomes a grocer. The four apprentices are enrolled by a captain to a crusade under the leadership of Robert Duke of Normandy. They suffer a shipwreck due to the thunderstorm and all the four brothers get separated from each other. After some years, Bella Franca also decides to go to Jerusalem, while the four brothers living separately in different parts of the world also happen to go to Jerusalem. In Jerusalem, the four brothers meet each other and their sister, but couldn't recognize each other because of the long time lapse. All the four brothers get infatuated by their young sister and try to woo her, but she continues to disregard their overtures. In the end, Bella Franca meets her old father. When the four brothers see their father, they recognize him, and thus the whole family gets together again. The play was specifically made to attract the favor of apprentices and the middle class of London. Later on, John Fletcher and Francis Beaumont heavily satirized this play in their own satirical play, The Knight of the Burning Pestle, that we have already discussed. Apart from romance, tragedies and comedies, Thomas Heywood also wrote some history plays. The two noteworthy history plays by Heywood are Edward IV, Part 1 and Part 2, and If You Know Not Me, You Know Nobody, Part 1 and 2, which was registered in the Stationer's Register in 1605. It is a chronological play divided into two parts. The first part depicts the main events of the reign of Queen Mary I and ends with the ascension of Queen Elizabeth. The second part concerns the Wars of Roses and the life of Queen Elizabeth, along with the simultaneous rise of the merchant and financier Thomas Gresham, who established the Royal Exchange in London. This play was subtitled The Troubles of Queen Elizabeth, as it explicitly shows all the major troubles that Queen Elizabeth faced during her reign, including the attempted assassination plot by Dr. William Parry and attempted invasion by the Spanish Armada. The play echoes with the title of another play by Samuel Rowley, which was titled When You See Me, You Know Me, and was based on the life of King Henry VIII and was also produced in 1605. Heywood wrote some masques, and the most successful of his masques was Love's Mistress or The Queen's Mask, which was produced during the Caroline age and was first performed for King Charles I in 1634. The play was so liked by King Charles I and his wife Queen Henrietta Maria that they watched the play three times within a span of 8 days. The mask tells the story of Cupid and Psyche as told by the classic Roman prose writer Apuleius. Heywood was a prolific prose writer and wrote some noteworthy essays. His essay, An Apology for Actors, was first published in 1612. Apart from being a playwright, Heywood was an active actor too. During the Jacobean and Caroline era, the London stage was facing strong opposition from Puritans who wanted to abort all stages and dramas as they considered it sinful. In his essay, Thomas Heywood defends actors and gives a strong rebuttal to the Puritans opposing the London stages of drama. A Woman Killed with Kindness is considered the best work by Thomas Heywood, which was first performed in 1603 and was published in 1607. Heywood derived the plot of this drama from an Italian novel by Ilissini, which was translated into English by William Painter and was titled The Palace of Pleasure. Many other Elizabethan and Jacobean dramas, including Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, Timon of Athens, Edward III, and All Is Well That Ends Well, John Webster's The Duchess of Malfi, Beaumont and Fletcher's Triumph of Death, and James Shirley's Love's Cruelty were derived from Painter's translation, The Palace of Pleasure. A Woman Killed with Kindness is a tragedy. The story is about a newly wedded couple of Master John Frankfort and Annie Frankfort. The couple was leading a perfect married life until Frankfort invites Vandal, one of his close friends, to live with them for a few days as his companion. Frankfort starts ignoring his wife to spend more time with Vandal. On the other hand, Vandal is enamored by Annie, whom he finds very attractive. While Frankfort is unaware of the increasing attachment of Vandal with Annie, Vandal expresses his love to Annie in private. At first, Annie is shocked by this revelation by Vandal, but gradually she melts and gets overwhelmed and seduced by Vandal. One of the loyal servants of Frankfort, Nicholas, comes to know about the affair of his mistress and Vandal. He informs Frankfort about it. Frankfort gets suspicious and he devises a plan along with Nicholas to confirm the infidelity of Annie, whom he loves so much. One day, he goes out of home with Nicholas and says that Annie and Vandal should take dinner as he will return late at night. Vandal persuades Annie to take dinner in her bedroom, where he plans to have a sexual dessert after dinner. Meanwhile, Frankfort and Nicholas sneak into the house without the knowledge of Vandal or Annie. After dinner, when Vandal and Annie engage in lovemaking, Frankfort catches them red-handed. He chases away Vandal and shows his disappointment at Annie. He calls his children into her bedroom and chides her in front of them. Though he avoids violence, he decides to ostracize Annie and tells her that she can take all her belonging, all money she needs, and the best and favorite of the servants and go away to live in his second house, which is 7 miles away. He further says that now he wants to keep no link with Annie and she should never try to meet him or any of his children in the future. Saddened, Annie leaves home to live alone in Frankfort's second house. While Frankfort told her to take all her belongings with her, Annie leaves her lute at home. When Frankfort sees it, he becomes sad. He sends Nicholas to give the lute to Annie. When Nicholas reaches Annie's new home, where she is living alone, he sees that Vandal is trying to approach Annie again, but Annie chases him away, claiming that he is the devil that ruined her life. He gives the lute to Annie. Annie tells him to swear that he will inform Frankfort how sad and sorry she is, and she has renounced food till her death, as she cannot live without her family. Nicholas goes back home and informs Frankfort. Frankfort decides to visit Annie and soothe her. He visits Annie along with his friend Charles and Suzanne. When Frankfort reaches his second home to meet Annie, he finds her on the deathbed. He shows his affection to her and forgives her, which soothes her. However, self-starvation has made Annie too weak. She succumbs to weakness and dies. The other plot of A Woman Killed with Kindness includes Charles, Suzanne, and Francis Acton. Charles is another close friend of Frankfort and Vandal, while Suzanne is his wife. Sir Francis tries to seduce Suzanne by helping Charles financially and taking back murder charges against him. But when he comes to know about what happened between Frankfort and his sister Annie, he gives up his illicit desires. The English Traveller was another successful drama by Thomas Heywood, which was first performed in 1627 and was printed in 1633. This drama is a tragicomedy that has two plots. While the main plot is tragic, the subplot is comic. The tragic story is similar to that of A Woman Killed with Kindness. The titular character is young Geraldine, who loves a young girl, though he couldn't marry her because of his frequent travels. He finds out that his beloved has married one of his father's old Geraldine's close friend by Wincott. Old Geraldine, Wincott and Wincott's wife all love young Geraldine, and Wincott is too generous towards him. Young Geraldine has a close friend, Dalyville, with whom he shares his secrets. When young Geraldine finds Wincott's wife alone, he confesses his love and regrets that he couldn't marry her because of his traveling schedule. Both of them promise that they will be together again as lovers in the future. However, Dalyville is also trying to seduce Wincott's wife. He informs old Geraldine about the brewing affair between young Geraldine and Wincott's wife. When old Geraldine comes to know about his son's intentions, he restricts him from visiting Wincott's house. Young Geraldine is saddened, but he manages to sneak out and visits Wincott's house secretly to meet Wincott's wife. However, when he reaches there, he overhears Dalyville and Wincott's wife's intimate talks and is filled with despair. He decides to go back to his traveling. Before leaving, he confronts Wincott's wife and chides her. She dies of despair, sadness and regret. The comic part of the play includes another father-son duo of young Lionel and old Lionel. Old Lionel is a wealthy merchant and young Lionel is his prodigal, wasteful son. So we have discussed six major works by Thomas Heywood. The Four Prentices of London was a romance performed in 1594. If You Know Not Me, You Know Nothing was a historical chronicle drama based on the life of Queen Mary I and Queen Elizabeth I and Thomas Gresham, which was performed in 1605. Love's Mistress or The Queen's Mask was a mask which was performed for King Charles and his wife Henrietta in 1634. A Woman Killed with Kindness was a tragedy performed in 1603, and The English Traveller was a tragicomedy with one tragic and one comic plot, and it was performed in 1627. This is it for today. We will discuss other important authors, playwrights, and poets of the Jacobean and Caroline era in the upcoming videos. Please stay connected with the discourse. Thanks and regards.